Today I'm going to walk you through how to do an RMA wizard for Silver Peak SDWAN Edge Connect appliance, and due to hardware failure, or it could be out of service appliance to replace with a new product line. Hello and welcome to Tutorials with Tips. This is a place where I talk about IT, my journey, and some unique topic that not many people have discussed. Well, this is not how I exactly plan to start showing or making videos on Silver Peak SDWAN. I had plans to kind of bring it to you a high level 10,000 foot view of what is SDWAN, but hey, a situation called for it, so I'm making a video and sharing with my team member. Decided why not do the same for my viewers. So this Edge Connect appliance, ECVITL1, of course, it's a virtual Edge Connect, and it's in an Italy location, has gone out, for example, in a hardware failure. It's still up here, as you can see, but we're going to simulate that. Okay, well, this is down, this is not working. How are we going to replace this? And this could be very easily done using Silver Peak Orchestrator. So in the real world and for a physical appliance, this may be a little different, but as long as you plug in the management interface and go ahead and go through the configuration wizard and bring it to where your orchestrator can see that appliance in the Discover Appliance page, and as long as you do that, then you're fine. But for me, I'm just going to from scratch install a new Edge Connect virtual appliance. So here we go. Alright, so I have completed installing the ECV, Edge Connect Virtual Appliance. It would be equivalent to you powered your physical Edge Connect product and you connected the management portal. Now, the activation works differently for management hardware devices, where the serial number is already tied to your account, so it already communicated to Orchestrator and should be ready to be discovered. But for Edge Connect Virtual, the process is a little lengthy. We need to make sure that we assign MAC addresses and we go ahead and log into the web portal and assign those MAC addresses to individual interfaces like management, LAN, WAN, all that stuff. So just follow with me on this one. Okay, so we're gonna add the network adapter. Make sure you do one at a time. Otherwise there will be consequences. So this is going to connect to the Italy switch LAN, and I always try to pick the NAT3 adapter type. So okay, I'm gonna hit save. I'm gonna go right back into it and do it again a couple more times. So fast forwarding it. Okay, we have done added all four network adapter. First one for management, and we have LAN0, WAN0, and WAN1. So let's take a look at these. They will, as you can see, that they've already been assigned the MAC addresses 3A61 for LAN0, and then we have for WAN0. 3A6B. All right, so let's take a look and log into the web GUI. That's 16.167 PS. Default password admin. All right, configuration, initial configuration wizard. All right, so here you can change the name, but for RMA wizard, it's not needed. Let's take a look at it. By default, you have your management zero configured. I'm just gonna go ahead and check these first before I even check them all. Here it is why, because they are done separately, like one nick at a time. So I know in that order, they will be listed here. If you hadn't done so, you would have had to go in each time and you would have had to look for the MAC address for each adapter to match LAN 0 MAC address to your LAN 0 interfaces, right? So I know this for a fact. That's why I done that this way. It was a lesson learned during my lab creation. By the way, this is my lab and this is not a active production, so we should be good if I make any mistake. Next point is I need to go ahead and save this. No, I don't want to reboot, but I would like to get my license information, which is orchestrator cloud portal. There you go. I'm just gonna copy this and go ahead and put it in there. This is one step that you're having to do for a virtual appliance because it doesn't come with a physical MAC address. So that's why you're having to add this account information. So this particular device can contact Cloud Portal and be ready to be discovered under your orchestrator. All right, so we have to reboot this after you added that. So let's come back when it is done. All right, my device has come back. The password is still admin. This is just, I've been configured with the right MAC addresses and account name and key. So it should be ready to be discovered under my appliance, the orchestrator. Let's find out. Discovered appliances, right? We're gonna do refresh and here it is, our EF40BC. It's right here. It has been discovered. So now I'm not gonna do anything. If it was a brand new site, I would have gone through the approval process. And but this is not an approval. This is not a new site. This is just a RMA, right? So I'm going to replace this ECV-ITL with this new one that it is waiting in my discovered portal. So here you just look for RMA, and the process is so streamlined. Just since you are replacing this one with this one, that is correct. It says everything is similar, and now it is at least the model, right? You cannot migrate or you cannot do RMA wizard between two physical appliances that are not the same model. Plan to make another video with that. I just received my hardware devices. So all right, so now we are in the second page where you need to define which one do you want to take. I would like to use this one because this one's the latest and this one was done earlier today initial, right? So I can do that. During this process, you also can upgrade your appliance to the current version. My current appliance ECV-ITL is running 9.5, the same version. So this is recommending you to go ahead and take that same one. So I'm going to upgrade them at the same time while it is doing RMA wizard. So let's go. All right, so this process is gonna go. It is gonna revoke the existing license. You will see my current ECV1 ITL is gonna go offline from the left. And then it's going to go and shut down existing appliance. Go ahead, updating orchestrator, then upgrade the appliance to the new ECOS, Edge Connect operating system, and then restore the config all from the orchestrator. I understand, guys. I've been working with Cisco and Aruba switches and other appliances, but I have never seen an RMA process or replacing it is so easy, right? You just plug into the network and you go through this wizard and that's it. The other device would be shut down and you just take it off the rack and send it back to Silver Peak. So I'm gonna just fast forward this section and come back when they are finished. So while this is going on, just wanted to show you this is my hypervisor where I have these two appliances. ECV1 ITL, you know that's my new one, that with the IP167, and the current one which I'm replacing is ECV-ITL1. If you go back here, you can probably still see my old one. Old IP address is probably 165. Anyway, so now as you have seen that the old one gone offline, it is going through the upgrade process, the ECOS upgrade process for the new one. As soon as it comes back, it's going to just slap the config. It should be ready. Just wanted to show you this, that this particular device has already been shut down. So RMA wizard is working as expected. All right, so restoring config was successful. So the wizard successful completed. Now are we waiting for this particular device to come? As you can see, this device still taking the old name, the default name, just like here, EF40BC. But I am expecting as it comes online into my orchestrator dashboard, it will just show the name what it was before, ECV-ITL. Let's take a look. I'm going to refresh it. All right, just waited a little while, and as you can see, it come back with the name, and you can also see the new IP 16.167, and it is currently synchronizing. So there you have it, folks. A very easy RMA wizard to replace your faulty edge connect or out of life cycle edge connect with the new one. Oh, almost forgot the last step. You need to go ahead and delete the one you just RMA'd. For physical appliance, you simply need to unplug it and take it off the rack. That's always a good practice. So unfortunately, mine is a virtual. I'm going to delete that so I don't make mistakes turning them on. They were already declined on the orchestrator. All right, this is it. Thank you.